Happy Easter to you, and welcome and greetings to you on this Easter day. I'm broadcasting here from the rectory in Great Yarmouth, and to all members of our churches here in the Parish of Great Yarmouth, that's Great Yarmouth Minster and St Paul's and St Mary's, and anyone else who happens to be watching with us this morning, greetings and welcome to you. Some of you will have got the order of service which you can follow, and at home please do join in the responses, and it's wonderful to connect with you and share with you on this Easter day. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega, all time belongs to him and all ages. To him be glory and power through every age and forever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. And so, wherever you may be, I invite you to join with me as we prepare to meet the risen Lord this day. Almighty God, your Son has opened for us a new and living way into your presence. Give us new hearts and constant wills to worship you in spirit and in truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. Like Mary at the empty tomb, we fail to grasp the wonder of your presence. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Like the disciples behind locked doors, we are afraid to be seen as your followers. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Like Thomas in the upper room, we are slow to believe. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Almighty and merciful Lord grant you pardon and forgiveness of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and strength of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We join together in the praise of God as we say the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us keep a moment of stillness and silence as we pray that we may know the joy of the risen Lord. God of glory, by the raising of your Son, you have broken the chains of death and hell. Fill your church with faith and hope, for a new day has dawned, and the way to life stands open in our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went towards the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scriptures, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." She told them that he had said these things to her. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We are the body of Christ. Now, of course, normally at this time on Easter Day, we would now be gathering in our churches. We would be sat there alongside one another. Many visitors would come and join us to share in the great joy of this occasion. We are the body of Christ still. Not in the same place, not in the usual place where you would find us on Easter Day. But we are the body of Christ, separated, scattered, isolated. Much like the disciples, after the crucifixion of Jesus, they scattered, they were gone, they were frightened, isolated, they felt like they lacked hope, they had no idea. And then in the unfolding of a new dawn at Easter, they encounter, the first encounters with the risen Christ take place. Mary, Simon Peter, and the other disciple who Jesus loved are the first to encounter, and those disciples go back and tell the news. The encounter with Jesus, the encounter with the risen Jesus, is unlike anything else. The body which they saw just those days before, broken, despised, hanging, crucified, spoke of a hopeless situation, one which drove them to despair and scattered them all. And yet, in the body of Christ, there is newness and there is hope. That which is broken, scattered, that which is wretched, that which is ruined and wrecked, is made whole again. Wherever you may be, as you listen, as you watch, as you join with us this day, dwell on those thoughts. And wherever you are, remembering that the first encounters with the risen Jesus were just in a garden or walking alongside the road, wherever you may be, may you know that Jesus is risen for you, and the wonder of his saving presence with each and every one of us, for we are the body of Christ. So, as the body of Christ, brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess the faith of the Church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. Let us pray. We pray to Jesus, who is present with us to eternity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For your people this day, for the body of Christ here on earth, for those who are scattered, those who are isolated, we pray that you would fill our hearts with fresh hope. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are affected by the coronavirus, through illness or isolation, those who are worried, that they may find relief and recovery and reassurance. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Pray for those guiding our nation at this time, those members of our government and those who support and advise them, that they may make wise decisions. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, our way, our truth, and our life, be with us and all who follow you in the way. Especially we pray at this time, when your church is scattered, we pray that we may never feel alone, but rejoice in your risen presence with us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, Good Shepherd, who gave your life for the sheep, recover the straggler, bind up the injured, strengthen the sick, lead the healthy and strong to new pastures. And we hold in our hearts those whose needs are especially close to us this day, and those who've asked for our prayers. Jesus, Lord of life, in your mercy, hear us, accept our prayers, and be with us all always. Amen. Of course, the risen Christ could not be bound or contained by locked doors or limited in any kind of way. And so now, as I share the peace with all of you, and knowing that that peace of Christ is with us, is real, is in our hearts, and as surely as with you, as with me and everyone else. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Be present, Lord Jesus Christ, our risen High Priest, and make yourself known in the breaking of bread. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty Father, and in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise, and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." of me.
Jesus Christ is Lord. Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. And so we join together, praying with Christians across the world and down the ages, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
God of life, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection have delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his risen life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Wherever you are, wherever you're watching this, I wish you all the joys of this Easter and the blessings of Christ. And whatever you're up to, whether you are isolated and on your own, and or whether you've got your family there with you, and I hope that you have a wonderful day, and do look after each other, to stay safe and be ever mindful of the needs of neighbours. So may Christ, who out of defeat brings new hope and a new future, fill you with his new life, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.